deletion and duplication. Okay, that is a characterized by how you can characterize. So they are creating a loop. Loop means like that. So they are creating what? Loop in the chromosome. Okay, so we have to see that. What I told, deletion and duplication is characterized by creating loop in one chromosome. How you can characterize? So that is having what? They are creating loop. This is you have to remember. Deletion and duplication creates what? Loop in one chromosome. Okay. Now the translocation, what we seen now, the translocation in one chromosome, what we seen in one chromosome, deletion and duplication. If both the chromosome containing loop, so that is characterized by inversion. What I told, inversion is characterized by loop present in two chromosomes. If one chromosome they are having loop, so that is what? That is showing deletion. If both two chromosome containing loop, that means they are showing inversion. Okay, then translocation. So translocation are characterized by formation of plus shaped structures. What we can say, translocation is characterized by plus-shaped structure present on chromosome. Okay, they are by plus-shaped structure, and where they are showing at the time of zygotene. Okay, so at the time of zygotene, stage of prophase one of meiosis one. Okay. And this is the more important that you have to understand. Okay, translocation characterized by plus shaped structure. Okay, and it is found in the time of zygotene. Okay, so these are what we seen, that we seen chromosomal aberrations. That is first structure due to change in structure. Now come on, change in chromosome number. So that is known as genomic mutation or genomatic mutation. So next is, come on that. Next one is genomic mutation or genomatic mutation. This mutation occurs due to चेंज इन क्रोमोसोम नंबर. Okay, previous one was structure change, but here what is that? Chromosome number change, and hence it is known as genomic or genomatic mutation. Okay, now this genomic or genomatic mutation contains set of chromosome. Okay, that is set of chromosome, and that is having some type. And what are the types are there? So we can say it is of two types. And the first type is aneuploidy and next type is euploidy. So first is aneuploidy. And second is euploidy. Aneu means without true set of chromosome. And euploidy means they are having true set of chromosome. Okay, so one by one we'll see these two, aneuploidy and euploidy. Okay, now if we are seeing this aneuploidy, so they are further having some type. What are the types are there that we have to see? So before going into that, we have to do what? We have to see in a graphical formation, then we will understand it better. So come on that, then we'll come on one by one. So what I told, second is genomic mutation, that is having aneuploidy or euploidy. So we are just seeing with the help of variation in chromosome number, variation in chromosome number. So we can say this is ploidy. Okay, what we can say? Ploidy. And this is already I told, this is having two types. So one is aneuploidy and one is euploidy. Okay, one is aneuploidy, one is euploidy. Now, this aneuploidy, if chromosome number is having lost, okay, one or two, not complete set, only some chromosome. So that is, it is further having hypoploidy and hyperploidy. So hypoaneuploidy. Hypo means below, less. And this one, hyper. Aneuploidy means higher, more. Okay. Now, this hypoploidy further having two types. What are the types of that? First is a monosomy. We'll discuss one by one. Monosomy. Now it is reported by 2N-1. So monosomy, this symbol you have to remember. Monosomy means one less. Next is nullisomy. It means 2N-2. So that is nullisomy. Okay. If we are seeing hyperploidy, means higher, more. So under that, first is trisomy. So this is denoted with 2N+1, one more. Next is double trisomy. Double trisomy. So how we can So this 2n plus 2. Next is tetrazomy. Okay. Sorry, double trisomy. 2n plus 1 plus 1. Okay. And next is tetrazomy. So tetrazomy denoted with 2n plus 2 means only one chromosome will increase by 2. And here one chromosome and another non-homologous chromosome will increase. So that we will see in later. So this is what tetrazomy. Now in euploidy, that is true set of chromosome like 1n, 2n, 3n, 4n means a haploid set of chromosome is increasing. That is true set of chromosome. Okay. So here first is monoploid. Just for example, n or 1n. Next is diploidy. Diploidy, that is 2n. And next is polyploidy. Polyploidy comes under 3n, 4n, 5n, 6n. Okay, so 3n means triploid, tetraploid, pentaploid, hexaploid. 7n means septaploid, 8n means octaploid. Okay, so like that it is coming. Okay, next we have to come on what are the things will come. Already we have to see, but just for one line questions you have to see what are the things are coming. So come on, that this is very important, you have to remember this chart. So one by one we have to see. First we have to see monosomic condition. Monosomic means 2n minus 1. Okay, monosomic means 2n minus 1. So here what happened? Organism lose one chromosome. Okay, organism what doing? Losing or lost one chromosome. So here organism lost one chromosome. Okay, here organism doing what? Lost one chromosome. Okay, and just for example, Turner syndrome, we will see entire detail the syndrome, genetic disorder. So here example, for example, Turner syndrome. Now next monosomic, after that next is nullisomic. Nullisomic, this will be represented as 2n minus 2. So how much chromosome will lost here? It has what? It has a deficient in two chromosome. It has deficient in two chromosome. So this is nullisomic. Now this you have to remember, Turner syndrome belongs to what? Monosomic. Okay. Now this is nullisomic. Third one is a trisomic, that we seen hyper. So third is trisomic. Trisomic means 2n plus 1. Okay. Now trisomic plus 1 means what we can say? Here one extra chromosome present. Okay. One extra chromosome present. Okay. So here organism contain one extra chromosome. Here one extra chromosome present in the organism. Now this trisomic condition, वॉज फर्स्ट स्टडीड इन दतुरा एस्ट्रोनियम. वेयर इट स्टडीड? इट वॉज फर्स्ट स्टडीड इन दतुरा एस्ट्रोनियम. ओके, दिस दतुरा एस्ट्रोनियम कॉमनली नोन एज जिम्पिसन वीड. Okay, this is known as Jimpison weed, and full name is Datura stomium stramonium. Stramonium. Okay, so this is the where it is studied first in Jimpison weed. It is a plant where it studied, and that was studied by A.P. Blaxley scientist. By A.P. Blaxley. This question already asked in JIPMER. That a trisomic condition first studied in Datura stomium stramonium. Full name is there. Okay. So this you have to remember where it first studied trisomic. Okay, now if we are seeing in human beings, so what is that? Down syndrome is there, and that is having, for example, Down's syndrome or mongolism occur due to trisomy of chromosome number 21. We'll discuss this in detail in this chapter, but now you just understood that Down syndrome due to what? Due to trisomy or trisomic conditions. Okay, now next come on tetrasomic. Okay, next is tetrasomic. Now tetrasomic means it contains two extra chromosome. Okay, it contains how much? Two extra chromosome. So it contains two extra chromosome and denoted with what? 2n plus 2. So this is what? Tetrasomic conditions. Okay. Now already we seen that in the next one is euploid. So come on that. Euploid. That is, it contains already told true set of haploid chromosome. Okay, or what we can say, one set of chromosomes every, so it is U means true. So true set of chromosome present in the organisms, so that is showing euploidy. Okay, now already we seen haploidy is there, diploidy is there, tetraploidy is there, triploidy is there. Here we have to remember that if monoploidy is there, so which one is showing by that? So monoploidy shown by thallophyta, bryophyta and male honeybee. So for example, thallophyta Bryophyta, this example is important. And male honey bee. Okay, so this is shown monoploidy. Next we have to come diploidy. Diploidy means 2n set of chromosome. And here what, who will come? Like us, human being will come, then garden pea will come. Just for example, many are there. So for example, human being, and here 2n is equal to 46 chromosome. If we are seeing Pisum sativum, garden pea, so there 2n is equal to 14 chromosome. Okay, diploid is there. Now here more conditions are there. We have to come on this side. So triploidy means how much we can say? 3. Or this don't tell triploidy, we have to say, tell this one polyploidy. Under that we will see polyploidy. Okay, and under that triploid is there, tetraploid is there, pentaploid is there, hexaploid is there, septaploid is there, octaploid is there. Okay, so under that one example is there, that recently we have seen triticum. Okay, triticum astivum, that is wheat is there. So this questions came from this. For example, triticum astivum, and it is what? Hexaploid. Hexaploid. Okay, so this is what? Euploidy, true set of chromosome containing. Okay, so this is euploidy. Now if we are seeing this in the origin, so already we seen that on the basis of origin, what we have seen, spontaneous were there, then what we seen, then we seen induced mutation were there. Okay, but before going into that, we have to see that what are the third type. So third type is gene mutation or point mutation. So we have to see that third type. First we seen on the basis of structure, then we seen on the basis of chromosome number change. Now we have to see on the basis of nucleotide sequence. So third type is gene mutation. First chromosomal aberrations, then genomatic mutation, then third one is gene mutation. Now this gene mutation means what we can say? Change in nucleotide. Okay, change in nucleotide sequence. So that causes gene mutation. So what we can say here? Change in nucleotide takes place. Okay, now this gene mutation further having some type. Okay, this is having some type. So what are the types is there? So first one is a substitution gene mutation. So here we have to come. First is substitution gene mutation. Now, as a name suggests, substitution means something has been replaced. So substitution mutation, what we can say? Replacement of one nitrogen base by another nitrogen base. So here, replacement of one nitrogen base takes takes place by another nitrogen base. And due to that, mutation occurs, that is known as substitution gene mutation. Now, nitrogen bases are two types. One is purine, one is pyrimidine. We already know. Okay. So now come on, what first type? So here, the first type is transition. Substitution. Gene mutation. Okay, so first is what? Transition, substitution, gene mutation. Here what happens? Replacement of purine by purine, or replacement of pyrimidine or pyrimidine bases. Okay, so here replacement of purine by purine or replacement of pyrimidine by pyrimidine takes place. Okay, here either purine will replace by purine, either pyrimidine will replace by pyrimidine. So we have to see what happened here. Purine is adenine and guanine. Here, what is that? Purine is what? Adenine and guanine. So here replacement occurs like that. So this is transition, or pyrimidine cytosine and thymine . So this replacement if occur, that is known as transition. Now, next type is a transversion substitution gene mutation. So we have to see. Transversion substitution gene mutation. Transversion substitution gene mutation. Here what will happen? Replacement of purine by pyrimidine or vice versa. What I told here, replacement of purine base by pyrimidine or replacement of pyrimidine base by purine. Okay, so here what happens? Replacement of purine by pyrimidine or replacement of pyrimidine by purine base. So how it will occur? We already A, G and C and T. So here how if like that it will come. So this is what? This is transversion substitution gene mutation, because this is purine, this is pyrimidine. So purine replaced with pyrimidine and pyrimidine replaced with purine. So this type is known as what? Transversion. Okay. Now, next type of mutation in this after substitution is known as a frame shift mutation. So come on that, frame shift mutation. This is frame shift mutation. Now, frame shift mutation means what? We already know that genetic codes are present in the nucleotide. So, genetic code is read in groups of three nucleotides. Okay, they are ready. That is having what? That is a read in group of three nucleotides, and each trinucleotide is known as codon. So if any codon containing having any problem, the entire sequence will be changed, and that is known as a frame shift mutation. So what we can say, the genetic code is read in, okay, this genetic code that is read in groups of three nucleotides. Read in groups of three nucleotides, and these are known as, they are known as what? Codon. Okay, so these are known as codon. This trinucleotide is known as codon. Now, here what happens, if any changes occur in the sequence, that causes a frame shift mutation. Just for example, I am taking one sequence for the, one sequence is there, sequence. Just we are seeing that. One sequence is there. What is that? A C G A C G A C G A C G. Okay, many sequences are there. A C G A C G A C G. More one is there. A C G. So every three is known as what? These are known as codon. These are codon. Now, here what happens? If any problem happens due to addition or deletion, mostly that is happening due to addition or deletion. So what happens in the sequence, we have to see. Just for example, if sequence is there, one example we are seeing that it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Okay, now due to addition, just I am writing addition. So addition occur at which position? I am taking addition occurs at 9th position. And addition of what? A, adenine. Addition of adenine. So what will happen? A C G A C G A C G. This is the 9th position, and here we introduce A, and remaining same. A C G A C G. Okay, now here what happens, this is the right sequence, this is the right, this is the right, here this is what happens, the nucleotide codon has been changed, this is also changed, this is okay. So this creates what? Sequence of reading proteins has been changed. Okay, so this is known as what? Frame shift mutation. Now, if we are taking one example, just taken one another example of deletion. So frame shift mutation means if the entire sequence information has been changed due to addition or deletion, that is known as frame shift mutation. Just for example, deletion. Okay, so deletion what? Just we are saying that guanine. And taking an example, ACG, GCC, AAG, GCC, CCU. Okay, CCG. Now here, just giving one number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. And I am just telling that deletion occurs of G at which position? At position number 3rd. Here I am just telling. Okay. So what will be the frame? A, C, G. Then G, C, C. Then just